from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myle. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from an anonymous donor from Victoria, British Columbia. This Mass is offered in memory of her husband. May his soul and the souls of the faithful departed rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord, just like St. Justin the Martyr did about 1900 years ago, knowing that he was weak, knowing that all wisdom and guidance comes from God, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the folly of the cross wondrously taught St. Justin the Martyr the surpassing knowledge of Jesus Christ, grant us through his intercession that having rejected deception and error, we may become steadfast in the faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. I will now call to mind the works of the Lord, and will declare what I have seen. By the word of the Lord his works are made, and all his creatures do his will. The sun looks down on everything with its light, and the work of the Lord is full of his glory. The Lord has not empowered even his holy ones to recount all his marvelous works, which the Lord the Almighty has established so that the universe may stand firm in his glory. He searches out the abyss and the human heart. He understands their innermost secrets. For the Most High knows all that may be known. He sees the signs of the age. He discloses what has been and what is to be, and he reveals the traces of hidden things. No thought escapes him, and nothing is hidden from him. He has set in order the splendors of his wisdom. He is from all eternity one and the same. Nothing can be added or taken away, and he needs no one to be his counselor. How desirable are all his works, and how sparkling they are to see. All these things live and remain forever. Each creature is preserved to meet a particular need. All things come in pairs, one opposite the other, and he has made nothing incomplete. Each supplements the virtues of the other. Who could ever tire of seeing his glory? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To him with a heart.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus and his disciples came to Jericho, and he and his disciples and a large crowd were leaving Jericho. Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus, a blind beggar, was sitting by the roadside. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout out and say, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." Many sternly ordered him to be quiet, but he cried out even more loudly, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stood still and said, "Call him here." And they called the man who was blind, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, he is calling you." So, throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. Then Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man said to him, "My teacher, let me see again." Jesus said to him, "Go, your faith has made you well." Immediately, Bartimaeus regained his sight and followed Jesus on the way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have the beautiful healing of Bartimaeus, and today's readings are very much about faith and wisdom. And Bartimaeus, he had the faith to see that he could get healed, but also he had the wisdom. Wisdom is something, it's hard to get a hold of, but wisdom, we could say, is something what we have been able to see. We see the things in life and we can put one and one together, and an infusion of the Holy Spirit. Seeing something, some people would call it the sixth sense, but seeing something what we cannot explain. And of course, Justin, he saw all of that and he sprang up and said, "Heal me." He would not, if he was sitting on the curb, I don't think today, and I came walking by, that he would say, "Hey, Hank, heal me," because he probably would know by faith that God would not give me that gift. And today is very much also in the first reading of Sirah. Sirah, which was written by Ben Sirah about 200 before BC in Jerusalem. And today he celebrates that wisdom in that book, the wisdom of God. And it's to be celebrated. And it's that mystery how, like our psalm says today, by the word of the Lord, the heavens were made. We cannot explain it. We can explain some things, but we cannot understand ever, because God is outside of space and time. And if you understand that, you might need some psychological help. But here we are. But today, also is the memorial of Justin the martyr, or Justin the philosopher, died in 165, and he's a beautiful account of an early martyr. We often think that during the Roman era, that the persecution just one after another, and that there was no rest for Christians, but there was. And he lived in a time of relative peace. And in about 155, he wrote two apologies. And the experts, they're talking about that those two apologies actually were one. And written to the Emperor Antoninus Pius, who was an emperor and a fairly calm kind of a guy who had things under control. And it was written to his, to him and his family and the Senate. Now there's another line of experts who say that the two apologies, one was written to the emperor and the other one to the Senate. But nevertheless, his family member, Marcus Aurelius Antonius, who became in 161 the next emperor, under him, Justin was martyred. And Marcus Antonius, Antonius also was a philosopher, someone who could think, someone who was well versed in Greek philosophy and who could put one and one together. And it's interesting how it was written in about 155, but Justin the martyr did not get martyred until about 10 years later in 165. So it must have taken them some time to absorb it. And we often forget in those days, the Catholic faith, Christians, were generally, they were just slaves of people of very poor standing, who had very, the poor in society. It was really not the faith of those who had some knowledge. And we have, of course, Justin, the martyr, a philosopher, who was actually born in Israel, in today's Nablus, who had the knowledge, who was studied, well-versed in Greek philosophy, and who could put up a very good argument. And he did in his two apologies. And so when he got martyred, we have that beautiful account in front of, before the prefect Rusticus. Rusticus, the prefect of Rome, and he was denounced. It's a show trial, that's all it was. And so we have an extant account of that trial, someone who wrote down what was said. And it's very profound. And I invite you, it's in our breviary this morning, the second reading in our breviary in the morning office. But also, if you just go to Wikipedia and enter Justin the Martyr, you will read that too. Beautiful account of how the, he's called before the prefect of Rome, and there's this trial. And first of all, it is said, you know, he says, you know, what's wrong with you? You're Christian. But venerate the Roman gods. And Justin says, well, I'm not going to do that because I'm not stupid. I'm a Christian. And he says, so you are a Christian? Of course we're Christians. That's why we're here. Let's get on with it. And this beautiful account between the two of them, and it goes back and forth. And one of them, so the prefect Rusticus says, do you have an idea that you will go up to heaven to receive a suitable reward? And Justin says, it's not an idea that I have. It is something I know well and hold to most certain. Not afraid. He knows what his faith is about. And this is followed again, but Rusticus says, okay, let's get it done and over with. Venerate the Roman gods and you're off, or otherwise we're going to scorch you and murder you and it's going to be painful. And Justin again says, oh, but that's fine, you know, that's I'm glad to be martyred and it will be okay. And so sentence is given. He has six companions with him and they also say, yeah, we're Christians, you know, all is good. And so they go off gladly to get martyred. Beautiful account, and it's something for us to pray with, to how they had the wisdom, that insight, that wisdom which is very sacred, and that faith to trust in God and not to be afraid, And not to be afraid of that show trial in front of the prefect of Rome, Rusticus. Not to be afraid. So he joined joyfully, were beheaded. I don't know how that would feel if they beheaded me, how joyful I would be. But they were joyful. And what a sign of faith before the community. What a sign of faith for us 1900 years later, that that Christ is real. But we cannot, of course, touch, we can never explain the Christ, but how he is real and how by faith we walk. Amen. So let us bring our prayers before the Lord. May your annual celebration of the Feast of the Sacred Heart of Jesus renew and deepen our faith in his love for us. May he guide us as we seek to walk the path of mercy, compassion, and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those in the Daily TV Mass, in the Daily TV Mass Prayer Intention Book. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all political prisoners, that they will find strength and courage by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit along their suffering journey for justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers, and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, with praise and glory of his name, for our part in the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, we pray, O Lord, that we may celebrate worthily these mysteries which Saint Justin strenuously defended through Christ, O Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed mother, Saint Justin, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear your witness through Christ our Lord. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim. Indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, the order of bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. Refreshed by heavenly food, we humbly implore you, O Lord, that attentive to the teachings of Saint Justin the Martyr, we may abide at all times in thanksgiving for the gifts we have received through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donor for the gift of this Mass.